air raid sirens rang throughout Ukraine early Friday after explosions were reported in multiple cities. Local media outlets say blasts were heard in central Ukraine in Mykolaiv and Dnipro in the south, as well as in Kyiv and its surrounding regions. No word yet on possible damage and if there were casualties. The airstrikes come as Kyiv gears up for a major counteroffensive to retake its eastern and southern regions from Russian control. The accuser of former U.S. President Donald Trump pushes back during a cross-examination in the rape trial. Writer E. Jean Carroll is accusing Trump of raping her in the mid-90s. She told Trump's lawyer she did not scream during the alleged attack due to panic. The 79-year-old also denied she waited more than two decades to come forward with her accusation in order to sell more copies of her 2019 memoir. Trump has consistently denied Carroll's allegations. Provocative and deliberate. That's how security analyst Chester Cabalsa describes China's latest act of aggression in the West Philippine Sea. See, on Monday, a Chinese Coast Guard ship cut off a Philippine patrol vessel off Spratly's Island, causing a near collision. Manila's side was also shadowed by Beijing's Navy and Coast Guard ships and was even ordered to leave Philippine waters. Cabalsa says it appears China is being rattled since the momentum is clearly on the Philippines' side, having conducted its largest ever military drills with the U.S.
Very courageous and brave yung ginawa ng ating presidente, given that of course no, itong biggest military exercise right now would change the contours of regional security architecture, at nakita talaga natin yun, no? Mukhang nayanig si China. We are at our peak of momentum right now because what we are seeing from China are mere reactions. Mang-aasat at mang-aasat talaga yung China.
Mm-mm.
Because they're trying to provoke us kasi ang labanan dito yung offensive.
Mm-mm.
Kapag naasar si Pilipinas, doon natitira si China. Yun yung iniiwasan nating miscalculation.
The latest incident follows the meeting of Chinese State Councilor and Foreign Minister Qin Kang and President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Aside from the near collision, the Coast Guard also spotted over 100 Chinese militia vessels in Philippine waters. A case of international gaslighting, that's how Philippine Senator Risa Ontiveros described China's actions in the West Philippine Sea. She adds China's repeated harassment of Philippine vessels shows their complete disrespect for Manila's sovereignty.
So this is just the latest in a continuous and unbroken and apparently unrepentant string of incidents na hindi nila pwedeng sabihin na aksidente. May pananadya na talaga dito. Hindi niya kayang respetuhin yung ating national interest. And always, we Filipinos are the last line of defense for the Philippines. I hope the executive is not waiting for an even worse incident in order to finally put its foot down and tell China, tell Beijing off to cease and desist in these kinds of actions.
In other news, 227 more Filipinos from conflict-torn Sudan have safely crossed the border to Egypt. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says this now brings the total of evacuated Filipinos in Egypt to 340. Meanwhile, more help is on the way. A five-man team from the Philippine Overseas Workers Welfare Administration has left for Egypt to provide assistance to affected Filipinos.
Kami na magdadala ng mga tubig, pagkain, at saka financial assistance sa kanila. And we will just reassure them that yung pati mga pamilya nila, mabibigyan natin ng assistance. Dahil alam mo naman yan, nag-aalala yan na hindi sila makapagpadala sa pamilya nila.
Warring factions trying to take control of Sudan have plunged the country into chaos and thousands of different nationalities are fleeing the battle zones and nearby areas. A ceasefire agreement between Sudan's warring factions extended for another 72 hours. The army and paramilitary forces agreed to a new three-day truce amid ongoing evacuation efforts by various countries. The U.S., meanwhile, is concerned about ceasefire violations in Sudan, but it vows to continue finding a peaceful resolution to the conflict.
We're working very closely together to deal with the crisis in Sudan. Hopefully, working toward a more enduring ceasefire, cessation of hostilities, and helping to put Sudan back on the track that it was on to civilian-led government, while dealing with, I think, an increasingly challenging humanitarian situation there.
Over in Taiwan, four Filipinos were among eight workers killed in a blaze that hit a factory in Changhua County. The chairman of the Manila Economic and Cultural Office, Attorney Sylvester Berry III, says three of the four victims died of suffocation. The fourth died while in hospital. Four other Filipino workers sustained a minor injuries. Berry adds, the employer as well as the Taiwanese government have extended assistance to the victims.
Maganda pa diyan balita, the Taiwanese government is extending a financial assistance of 100,000 NTD every casualty.
Opo.
But that is in addition doon sa proceed ng insurance coverage sila under yung kanilang employer. Liban doon, sa OWA naman, meron silang yung mga namatay, meron silang death benefits of 200,000 pesos and 20,000 pesos for the burial benefits po. And in addition, kung merong mga anak, yung mga naman nasawi, eh, meron silang educational benefits.